While the nation debates restricting gun use, Kentucky has already gone the other way, opening up guns in places where they have never been allowed.
Tonight, WLKY investigative reporter Dwayne Pullman continues a closer look at the new Kentucky gun law and the controversy.
Get ready to see guns in places where they've been banned for decades, all thanks to a new Kentucky gun law that's so gun-friendly, one state lawmaker says, it'll open up Kentucky to a new Wild West. At Metro Hall Barry, a security guard keeps a close eye as a metal detector scans everyone who enters. It's a checkpoint designed to catch guns.
Well, no one ever brought a gun in.
Now, thanks to a new Kentucky law, guns have literally been scratched off the list of banned items here.
Now they can bring in the bin as long as it's open.
Are you comfortable with that?
Certainly. I trust law-abiding citizens.
Democratic State Representative Bob Dameron, with backing from the NRA, authored this bill last summer. It prohibits local governments and districts from banning guns.
The Constitution specifically protects a citizen's individual right to carry an open firearm for the protection of themselves, their family, and their property. It is unconstitutional from a standpoint of saying no guns allowed.
Dameron's bill overwhelmingly passed through the Kentucky legislature and into law.
I think it's terrible public policy.
State Representative Mary Lou Marzian, also a Democrat, was one of just 10 state lawmakers who voted against Representative Dameron's bill.
Do we really need to have that weapon right there that someone can just pull out and start shooting?
Gun owners are now allowed to openly carry guns at libraries, council and board chambers, community centers, and according to Representative Dameron, even on buses.
Someone riding on that bus needs to have the ability to protect themselves.
But TARC's executive director Barry Barker tells me at this point TARC's policy will remain. Guns, he says, are still prohibited on all TARC buses. Still, the new law has already green-lighted guns here at Kentucky's capital. In open city spaces like zoos and parks, the new state law goes even further, preventing any local ban on carrying concealed weapons.
We did not give them the power to limit the carrying of concealed deadly weapons in open areas such as parks and zoos.
And employees of special districts, like firefighters in suburban and rural fire departments, are now allowed to carry concealed weapons too, much to the chagrin of at least one local fire chief.
They don't expect to see a gun on that firefighter. It's not who we represent or what we represent.
Louisville's mayor, Greg Fisher, is concerned.
We were keeping all guns out of government buildings because, you know, sometimes heated exchanges take place in government buildings by disgruntled citizens. We felt like that was best for the safety of the employees of the city. We can no longer prohibit guns from coming into our buildings. Now, we can prohibit knives, but we can't prohibit guns. I don't think it's good for our city. I don't agree, but it is the law, and so we will comply with the law.
Just outside the mayor's office at Metro Hall.
I don't like it. I don't like it at all.
Barry, that security guard, is concerned too.
If the bad guys got a gun, the good guys ought to have a gun as well.
While people can now openly carry in firearms, Barry, who doesn't have his own weapon, says he'll be outgunned if they do.
This is an unarmed post.
So you don't have a gun?
I don't have a gun either.
Concerned or not, the new Kentucky gun rights law is now the law of the land. And while local leaders like the mayor say they'll work to overturn it, they admit there's little they can do right now but comply with this new law, opening up places to guns that have never seen guns before. Dwayne Pullman, WLKY News.
While the new law opens up guns in many places, firearms are still banned from being brought in at schools, colleges and universities, courts, jails and prisons.